The Art of Maz Adams Presents. So here's a tribute piece I did for the late, great Kenny Baker. Most of you probably know Kenny was most notably known for portraying R2-D2. He was actually inside R2, and in A New Hope, the first movie, which filmed in 76 and came out in 77. He was, you know, actually inside R2 unit in Tunisia under these really hot, miserable conditions. You know, this is all from what I understand. Obviously, I wasn't there. I wasn't even born yet. But he actually was responsible for kind of moving the head on R2 side to side and some of the lights and switches inside there. So you can only imagine what it was like in the desert and then actually being inside a droid. Very claustrophobic. So, you know, he did a lot of stuff for little reward at the time. And really, you know, Star Wars wasn't the empire it is today, you know, no pun intended. So it was sight unseen. So, you know, my hat's off to him. And obviously he went on to play other roles in the franchise, most notably also Papu, I believe, the Ewok. He actually kind of can be said to be responsible for Warwick Davis's career, and Warwick Davis is a great guy. He's had an amazing career. Believe he was supposed to, Kenny Baker, I mean, was supposed to portray, Wicket, and he got sick, and that kind of paved the way for a casting call where Warwick Davis, I believe his aunt or his mom, or one of the two, I can't remember who, heard about it, and he ended up becoming Wicket, and then from there, you know, he became a big Hollywood star, so I'm sure he owes Kenny Baker, you know, a bit of gratitude there. And I just wanted to do something to commemorate, you know, the life and legacy of Kenny Baker. He was always known to be a great guy and loved by his fans. He was always smiling and laughing. And obviously, you know, he was under 4 feet tall. He had a lot of physical issues and ailments. And he still had such a positive attitude and outlook on life. And he was one of the, just like a great ambassador to Star Wars. You know, always did the conventions, always loved to meet fans. And so this is the least I can do. And for this, I wanted to try a different medium, so I used some pastel brushes, because to me pastel is very soft and playful, and it kind of you know, is what I think of Kenny. So I went for that, and I also wanted to get some nice tones going on, so a lot of pinks and reds, you know, really jolly colors. Like I said, you'll see some purples and stuff like that. So it's pretty much, you know, I was getting a feel for how this works. I kind of started getting a feel for how to use the other brushes, more paint-like stuff. So for this, it was more or less trying to figure this out, and I didn't want to abandon it, because with these things, it takes so long to build up before you feel like you're going anywhere, and it's just a lot of layering, honestly, so much layering. You just gotta kind of stick with it and go back and forth. You may go over with a red, then go back over with a black, then go over with a white, then go over with, you know, it just, you keep going and going, and you have to believe it's gonna go somewhere you like. And even though I'm not a pastel fan in real life, it's kind of cool to play around with them here. And the main reason I don't like pastels or charcoals or even pencil is because I smear a lot and I don't like the texture and the feeling. So to be able to have a program where you can get these brushes to kind of duplicate these other materials, it's really cool, because I can play around with things that I've never really played around with before, or that, you know, I haven't played around with in years, and try them in different ways. And people, you know, have also asked me, well, what's the benefit? Is, you know, is drawing digitally really like drawing? Yes and no. There's definitely a different feel to it you have to get used to. But to me, it's a little bit easier in the way that you're eliminating the variables. What I mean by that is, if I'm painting in real life, and I want a color, I have to mix that color. And once I run out of that color, it's gone. I have to remix it. It's hard to get that exact tone again, which anyone who paints can really attest to. When you're doing it digitally, you pick that color, bam, that's the color. You can come back to that color, you can save that color. So it cuts out a lot of the work and a lot of the frustration. So, I mean, that's one of the positives to it. And also, the only thing is, you know, it's a lot more clicking and changing, so it speeds it up, but it slows it down. Because if you want to change a brush size or something like that, you have to click. So it's definitely got its, you know, its drawbacks and its pros as well. So you see here, I was trying to go a little bit darker. because every time you go over these darker lines, it lightens up when you want to add colors like purples or pinks to the face. And I also find it's a lot harder when you're drawing digitally to say this is it, you know, that I'm done, to know when you're done, because you don't want to overdo it. And to me, that's the hardest part anyway, is to know when you're done, because I feel like I can keep going forever and ever with this stuff. Like, I'm sure you'll see here, there's a lot of pinks, a lot of purples, and I try to subtly bring that back down. I'm kind of bouncing all over here with what I'm talking about, but it's kind of cool, actually, just watching the process after, because you don't really get to see it come along so fast. You can't see it until after, obviously. I think this is like a 10-minute video. This was about a 4-hour drawing. I'm just watching it and honestly admiring what I'm doing here. Not in a arrogant way, but just admiring the technology of seeing it. And I just really liked this picture of Kenny. So normally I do, you know, normally the thing to do is the R2. And you'll see as I go on, I try to incorporate the colors of R2. I put a red tie. He's obviously got blue eyes, so I was able to do that. Here I'm starting to play with the hair a little bit, and I can't, like, impress upon people how much, you know, practice really matters. I've been drawing for so long, and I've seen in the past 3 years a huge progression that's, you know, I'm very proud of, and I want to keep continuing towards. I draw every day, you know, even though I have a regular job, I freelance. And, wow, I think I've pretty much reached my limit of talking on these videos, I think, because there's not really much else I can say. Here you see I try to put some blue in the shirt. Just trying to put the background. I just love how, you know, you can see the texture in there. It's just amazing. You wouldn't be able to tell it. This is digital. If I didn't tell you, or if you didn't see it being drawn. And I'm just having a ton of fun with this thing. Anyway, I'll let you continue to watch the video, and I'll shut up. And I appreciate you guys checking it out. Hopefully I'll have something new to add in the future. I have some cool pieces coming up. Been very blessed to have been asked by a bunch of Star Wars actors to do a bunch of pieces of them, which is crazy to think about, because I literally grew up a huge Star Wars fan. I'm like trivia crazy Star Wars fan. I still am a huge Star Wars fan. My love just grows every day. So when some of these guys reach out and gals and ask me, you know, or tell me they like my artwork and when they draw them, it's just very humbling and just very, you know, I can't process it really. I just feel very blessed. I just love doing what I do, and if anyone else enjoys it, you know, that's gravy to me. But thanks for joining me, and hopefully you'll enjoy the rest of this video.